In just a few hours' time, the Eurovision Song Contest will be broadcast on BBC One. Well, Cheryl Baker, Mike Nolan and Jay Aston know exactly what it feels like to win that Eurovision crown. As members of Bucks Fizz, they took the prize in 1981 with Making Your Mind Up. And in case you'd forgotten, they also had one very special dance move. And try to look as if you don't care. Well, now, here they are. That was 28 years ago.
Oh, yes, we were only three.
And whose idea was it to rip the skirts off?
Mine.
Mine. I don't know. Actually, there are so many people that claim to come up with that idea, including me. I said I came up with it.
Well, you did.
Did
it's
I?
Just that I wanted the minis, you wanted the longs, and you said, OK, let's rip them off in the middle.
No, it was me.
So it was Cheryl's idea.
But this was a group put together specifically for Eurovision.
A few weeks before.
Yeah.
It was like making a cake. They wanted exactly the right recipe to put in.
But what came
Eurovision.
First, the group or the song?
Song.
The song.
Song was first.
You were chosen to sing that particular number.
Yeah,
I think they had Mike first.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we entered and we did the demo of it in the studio, then it's entered to the BBC to be picked.
And
for
why
the,
were we called Bucks Fizz?
And we were called Bucks Fizz because I'll tell you that one just in case you want to know. we were called Bucks Fizz because as they were mixing the song in the studio, Nicola, the girl who was behind the whole thing, said, anybody fancy a Bucks Fizz? And they said, oh, that's a good name, stick that name down.
Yeah.
And next thing, we were called a couple of months later and said, right, you four are now Bucks Fizz for the next couple of months. And
here
28 years later, we've still got it.
Did you think it was a good song when you first heard it, Making Your Mind?
Yes.
Yeah, I thought it was really catchy, but yeah. I didn't think we'd win. I think the skirt ripping
he
definitely.
He did. Mike thought we'd win.
And I was so confident.
And did you know that that moment, ripping the skirt off, was voted in 2005 by BBC viewers the most memorable Eurovision moment ever?
Wow.
Well, I'm not surprised. And actually, if you look at the Eurovision now, ever since we did that, it seems that lots of people use gimmicks, don't they? Because I think it's the gimmick that makes you remember the song.
Well, that's what I want to talk about next, because looking at the rehearsals for tonight's event, everyone's got fireworks, people coming out the sky, clouds, you know, flames. You can hardly hear the music.
Well, it's a Eurovision fire contest now, isn't it? I mean, it's just... I don't think it has. I mean, I hope it has tonight, but I just think it's just... I think it's lost its appeal.
Oh, I don't.
I really do.
I don't.
I just don't think this... It's all too much. It's like a showman.
When you're... Because you perform it live in front of a huge television audience, 100 million plus, what does that do to you? Were you nervous or were you able to enjoy it or...?
I can tell you what it does to you physically, but perhaps it's
not in too much detail.
It was pretty nerve-wracking, but really exciting.
Yeah, I mean, I can remember what happened, because Cheryl, they came to get us, and Cheryl wasn't there, and they said, where is she? I said, she's in the loo.
You don't have to share that with the public, darling.
When you started to perform for the first time, because you do a reprise at the end if you've won, but were you happy with the performance, or was it not as good as you could have done because of the nerves?
No, the performance that we won with was much better than the performance that we finished with, because the performance we finished with, they got the mics mixed up, and the girls were singing through the boys' mics, and we sang through the girls', and they were so excited, one of them...
I don't know which one.
..sang out a tune.
Oh,
what?
Dear, how awful.
But she didn't care.
I sang sharp the whole way through. I was
sharp.
So happy.
No, but it didn't matter.
Now, what is our girl Jade Ewan going through tonight at this moment?
Oh, she's so nervous.
Yeah, she'll be really nervous. But she seems like a real professional, and I think she's going to do really well.
Yeah.
And she'll have Andrew Lloyd Webber with her.
Yeah, which is going to give a great
moral
support.
Which must be a tremendous boost.
She's a great singer, and I think it's quite a repetitive song, which probably is a good thing, because, you know, for countries that don't speak English, if they keep recognising the same line, then it possibly is going to, you know, be in their favour. And our gimmick this year is Andrew Lloyd Webber, isn't it?
Yeah, and well, he's one of the world's most successful modern songwriters,
isn't
he?
Yeah, everybody knows him.
Yeah.
Well, a lot of the songs are all in English tonight.
Are they really?
There's a comment made on the programme the other night where they showed you all the songs that may... picking out the songs for the contest, and somebody said, I think it's Malta, and she has a lovely song in it, and she sings in her language.
And they said English in Malta.
Well, no, she's singing in English.
Yes, well, a lot of people do, but there is a Maltese language.
They sung in their own language, and they said, oh, this is different. No, it was, you're right, it wasn't Malta. But this girl sung in her own language, and they said, this is what they want in it, people in their own language.
But you've got to focus not only on the song, but on your reactions as the votes come in. You can't relax. There's a camera on you as the votes are coming in. And how nerve-wracking is
that? I think that's the worst bit.
It is the worst bit, because we only won by a few points, and I don't think anyone gave us top marks.
We
just had like a couple of points here and there, and it's just that thing, it sort of dribbles in. Or I mean, if you're like, in the last 5 years we've had very few points from the UK.
Not many
they
people,
must have felt terrible.
Not many people know that since the original four there have been 15 members. Well, in all there have been 15 members of Bucks Fizz.
Have they really?
Well,
we are three originals. So
the group is still going strong.
Yeah.
We're still going strong. We'll be working tonight, actually. After the Eurovision, we'll be going to a big club in London and performing at 1:30 in the morning.
Yes, so think of us.
You poor babies.
I like being called a baby.
I'd love to go on. Cheryl Baker, Mike Nolan, Jay Aston, thank you so much for
it's
coming
a pleasure.
In.
Thank you very much.
Coverage of Eurovision begins at 8 o'clock tonight on BBC One, should you be interested. You'll be interested in the weather from Alex Deakin.